Benedict sir, are you there, sir? Let's wait for 2-3 minutes for Dr. Benedict to join, please. Thank you. Hi, good evening, friends. Warm welcome to Insight In Depth. Today's program is simply unique because the topic is highly significant and transactional analysis is an outstanding key that would help us succeed in our academic life and personal life, and that would sharpen our communicative skills. And this program is organized by the research wing of Martha Blous Training College. And I am Dr. Joju, the coordinator of the research wing. Warm welcome everyone to this program. Today's resource person is a gem of a person. She gives plenty of talks to All India Radio as well. Dr. Shalini, she's an expert in transactional analysis. Warm welcome everyone. We would love you to share the poster and link to your colleagues, friends and students so that they can also benefit. Let's commence the program. Dear research scholars, you may begin the program.
Good evening, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, perfect.
Okay. Shall I start?
Please begin.
Okay. Education is not the preparation for life. Education is life itself. With these words of John Dewey, I extend a very warm good afternoon to one and all present over here. Respected Principal Dr. K.Y. Bandik, sir, distinguished guest for today's invited talk, Dr. Shalini S. Ma'am, Research Coordinator, Dr. Jojo John, sir, honorable dignitaries, teachers, mentors, and dear participants. I, Vinci Biju, on behalf of the Research Wing, Martha Blous Training College, welcome you all to another vibrant session of Insight In Depth program. Today, we are proudly presenting our 37th talk series. Let us begin today's session by seeking the blessings of the Almighty God. Thank you. Now, I invite Mrs. Anuja V.S. for the welcome address. Anuja, ma'am.
Yes, thank you. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Good evening, one and all. Respected principal, our distinguished guest, respected teachers, research scholars, student teachers, and all those who have joined from various institutions. Welcome to yet another session of Insight In-Depth Talk series organized by Mark Theophilus Training College, Trivandrum. This is the 37th talk series organized by Mark Theophilus Training College Research Wing. With a thankful heart, I welcome Dr. K.V. Benedict Sir, Principal, Mark Theophilus Training College, whose support and guidance helps the Research Wing to conduct many webinars. Hearty welcome to you, sir, to this program. Next, I would like to welcome our resource person, Dr. Shalini S., Assistant Professor, M.Ed. Department, Mark Theophilus Training College, Trivandrum. Today, she is presenting the topic, Transactional Analysis, the Key to Effective Communication. We are really grateful to have you here for this session. A warm welcome to you, madam, on behalf of everyone present here. Next, I would like to welcome the research coordinator of our institution, Dr. Jojo Jones, sir, a person with positive energy. With due respect and with great pleasure, I welcome you, sir, for this session. Finally, I extend my hearty welcome to all research guides, professors, assistant professors, teachers, research scholars, and students from other institutions. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Thank you, Anuja ma'am. Dear participants, I'm delighted to announce that today's resource person is one of our faculty members, Dr. Shalini S. ma'am, who's going to illuminate us with her expertise knowledge on the topic transactional analysis, the key to effective communication. Before we start our enriching session, let us know more about our resource person from Mrs.
Mika Suresh. Uh-huh. Thank you, Vince teacher. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Good evening and welcome once again to the 37th edition of Insight In-Depth Talk Series organized by the Research Wing of Mark Theophilus Training College, Nalanchira. I am extremely delighted and honored to introduce our speaker for the day, Dr. Shalini S., Assistant Professor, M.Ed. Department, Mark Theophilus Training College, Nalanchira. She has 3 university ranks to her credits, all from Kerala University. Second rank for BSc Home Science, third rank for her MSc Agriculture Extension, and fourth rank for M.Ed. She has 11 years of teaching experience and is a resource person in the fields of guidance and counseling, education planning and management, transaction analysis, stress management, and Makkal Koppam, an awareness program for parents. She is also a faculty member in Adult and Continuing Education, University of Kerala. She has presented 45 Shubhachintas and 2 COVID pandemic-related programs for the All India Radio. She has also worked as the associate editor of the Kerala University-approved journal, Teacher, Learner, and Society. She has guided 42 M.Ed. thesis. She is also the chairperson of San Jose Education Trust. We are excited to hear from you, ma'am. Thank you and have a nice day.
Okay, thank you, Mika. Shall I begin?
Ma'am, one moment. I just want to make some announcements. 1 minute. Okay. Thank you, Mrs. Mika. We are about to start the session. Few announcements and humble requests to all the participants. Kindly mute your microphone and please do not share your screen for an uninterrupted session. Kindly pin our resource person to view her presentation. If you have any query during the presentation, please type them into the chat box. We'll bring them up during the discussion session. Link for E-certificate will be provided only after discussion gets over. Kindly fill and share your thoughts and experience to help us to improve. Now, I request Shalini Ma'am to share her thoughts with us. Ma'am, please.
Good evening to all. Respected Principal Bendix sir, other faculty members and dear participants. The topic for today's presentation is transaction analysis, the key to effective communication. I think these two terms are quite familiar for all of us. And today I am going to present how transactional analysis influence the process of communication. Okay, shall I move to the presentation? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay, thank you. Thank you. As we know, communication is the exchange of information by so many ways, like speaking, writing, or using some other mediums. Okay. Through communication, we can exchange our feelings, thought, our views, attitudes, and our dreams. And communication brings people together and closer to each other. And also enable to explain what we are experiencing. Okay. But this communication is effective only when the sender and the receiver accept the message in the actual meaning. And then, how can we improve our communication? There are so many ways to improve our communication. As we know, that is simply and stay on message, engage your listener or reader, take time to respond, make sure you are understood, and develop your listening skill too. And the next one, body language is also important. Maintain eye contact, respect your audience, make communication a priority. And all these are some measures to improve our communication. But today, we are going to discuss about an amazing tool or a technique of communication, that is transactional analysis. This transactional analysis is a theory developed by Dr. Eric Byrne in 1950s. Transactional analysis was introduced in 1950s by San Francisco psychiatrist Eric Byrne. Transactional analysis has become a worldwide movement. It is a sophisticated theory of personality, motivation, and problem solving, which can be of great use of psychotherapists, counselors, educators, and business consultants. Actually, through this theory, he examined a person's relationship and interactions. Byrne actually took inspiration from Sigmund Freud's theory of personality and combining them with his own observation of human, and he put forward one most accepted theory, that is transactional analysis. And this transactional analysis can be used to address one's interaction and communication with the purpose of establishing and reinforcing the idea that each individual is valuable and everyone has the capacity to change and personal growth. Then this transactional analysis is a theory of interaction. Okay, as we know, interaction are the integral part of human existence. Human beings are social species that relies on cooperation to survive and thrive. Transactional analysis helps to develop proper interaction between individuals. The basic tenets of transactional analysis are believe in the intrinsic value of people. That is, I am okay, you are okay. Then people are responsible for their own thoughts, feelings, and behavior. And a person's own experience is of prime validity. Each person construct and decide his own destiny and can change those decisions. Problems are solvable. TA believes that all of us has worth, value, and dignity. And TA provides explanation to how our past memories can impact our current relationship, and also how our individual perception impact on relationships. Okay, next slide. Okay, then why we need transactional analysis? As we know, we are living in a fast-moving world where we have no time to identify others or recognizing their feelings, and now our world is confined to the four walls of the room. No doubt, it will damage the attitude, beliefs, and values of our life. The transactional analysis helps to maintain a better relationship among people. It is one of the most accessible theory of modern psychology. And why we need transactional analysis for better understanding, for better relations, and to identify ourselves and to understand how people relate to one another so that they may improve communication and good relationship. And another one is to enrich your dealings with people. The theory outlines how we have developed and treat ourselves, how we relate our communication with others, and also offers suggestions and interventions which will enable us to change and grow. And the one of the most important thing is that the philosophy of TA, that is, people can change, and we all have the right to be in the world and be accepted. That is the basic philosophy of transactional analysis. Then the following are the concept of transactional analysis. Everyone has the capacity to think, and people decided their story and destiny. Therefore, these decisions can be changed. People are okay. This each person has validity, importance, and equality of respect. I'm sure our destiny is determined by our own decision. Our destiny is not something we can't sit by and let happen to so. We need to take action on the opportunities we are presented with faith may open doors. According to International Transactional Analysis Association, transactional analysis is a theory of personality and a systematic psychotherapy for personal growth and personal change. As a theory of personality, transactional analysis describes how people can structure psychologically. As a theory of personality, transactional analysis gives us a picture of how people are structured psychologically and also helps us to understand our own methods of communication, and also gives an in-depth information of why people behave. That is one of the important questions in our life. Why people behave like this, and why I am behaved like this? Transactional analysis answer to all our questions. Okay, then transactional analysis elevates your thinking to a high level while raising awareness, so you can understand your own difficulties, your own dysfunctional behavior and communication patterns, and helps to develop deeper connection with self and the world. And this will help us for an effective communication. And Eric Byrne believed that we are all born okay. And we can, in other words, good and worthy. I'm sure we people are only responsible person to shape our life. The thing is that we have the power we have the courage to choose our happiness. Never allow anybody to spoil your happiness. You are the authority to shape your life, your destiny, and your dream. And another thing, can a person really change? Yes, absolutely can. From the words of Jimmy Dean, I can't change the direction of wind, but I can adjust my sail to always reach a destination. And according to TA, people can change at any stage, but we have the mindset to accept that change. We are ready to cope up with the change. We identify what all the things happening around us, and we should be able to cope up with those change, and our mindset is ready to accept those change. Then only we can change. And there is no age bar, we can change at any age. Then next we are going to analyze the basic concept of transactional analysis. The thing is that if we are acquainted with the following elements, no doubt it will help you to improve your personal as well as professional life.
Then transactional analysis is a technique which helps to understand the behavior of other person so that communication became effective. Understand human behavior helps to motivate, guide, and direct other people. Transactional analysis, the specialty is communication. This is just a definition for transactional communication. And next, we are going to discuss about the basic concepts of transactional analysis. And the first one is ego state. The Byrne believed that communication with others comes from three distinct parts of self, which he called ego state. The ego state are parent, adult, and child. The parent means having in way which we learn and react out our parents' behavior as adult. Then adult using logic and evidence to guide our behavior, not become emotional. And the child is replaying childish behavior as adult. And first of all, we are going to discuss some aspects of parents. And there's parents, it is our ingrained voice of authority. The parent ego state is about the behaviors and feelings that we were copied from our parents or from our early caregivers. Just when we think about the parental figures, then a set of instructions like don't do this, always do this, be this, stop doing this. When we think about these parental figures, these type of instructions came into our mind. Yes, we were conditioned by our real parents, sometimes teachers, older people, next door neighbors, aunties and uncles during our childhood days. Our parent ego state is made up of huge number of hidden and overt recorded playback. Every word, every movement, every action has an effect. No other person outside force has a greater influence on a child than a parent. In our childhood days, we heard from our parents that stop playing with food and finish it fast. Where did they learn to say this? Probably from their parents. Who learned it from their parents are now they are playing to their kids. This person is operating from a parental ego state when he or she is mentally playback old tapes from childhood. These recordings says such things as it's right, it's wrong, it's bad. There are so many instructions we heard during our childhood. And our parent ego state is evaluative part of us and evoke values-laden behavior. But actually, this value-laden behavior is not a necessary real value. But during our childhood days, we learned all these type of instructions as values. And so it is learned value, but no necessary, these are all real values. Okay. And there are two types of parents, that is critical parent and nurturing parent. And considering the critical parents, they are just like perfectionist parents. Believe that their children should be unblemished as possible. Of course, they know their people make mistakes. However, they believe that it is their duty to have their children make a few mistakes as possible. I don't know, is it possible for a parent? Okay. Then they are usually criticizing their children and their intention is to proper development of the child. But actually what is happening? This constant criticism can cause some serious damage to the child's mental health as well as their relationship with their parents. Okay. In fact, it can leave lasting damage. Overly critical parents can harm a child's self-esteem. That was actually happening after insisting so many instructions and after so many criticism. The child feels that he's nothing. Then it will leads to harm a child's self-esteem. Then we know authoritarian system demand this critical parent ego, but the time has changed and authoritarian systems has given way to democratic one. So the transactional analysis has its own relevance. According to transactional analysis, every child is okay. The child's needs are legitimate. The most desirable and beneficial form of interaction is a cooperative, non-violent, nurturing relationship. That is, our children expecting that type of relationship from us. This premise stands in contradiction with the functions and assumptions of a critical parents. Okay, they consider their child is not okay, and we familiar with it, we can see that some parents using bad words like stupid, bad, sometimes monkey, crazy, okay, to address their child. This is surely an unhealthy practice, and it may lead to lack of confidence, lack of self-respect among children, and a critical parent never satisfied, and their attitude affects the mental health of the child, and the child has a lack of security feelings. While in the case of a nurturing parent is considered as a child is okay, or a person is okay and ready to give strokes as he or she needs. Later we discuss about strokes. Then now certain characteristics of this nurturing parent. A nurturing parent has so many positive qualities, like a nurturing parent is always loving and caring relationship with their children. Then patience and love are another characteristics, and they convey a message that the children can do it. A wonderful, a positive message. A children can do it. And they are approachable and know the child's need and keep child's individuality. These are the characteristics of a nurturing parent. And they are open-minded and they are also easygoing. Okay. A nurturing parent can develop the following qualities. That is, the nurturing parent can develop trust, patience, responsibility, and empathy in their children. Okay, these are the characteristics of nurturing parent and critical parent. And the next ego state is adult. And learning to strengthen the adult is the goal of transactional analysis. That is, when a person is in his adult ego state, he or she is directed towards an objective appraisal of reality. Okay. Actually, our adult is our ability to think and determine action for ourselves based on received data. That is, we already received certain data regarding where we are living, the thoughts of the social groups, the feeling of the social group, the virtues, the customs, and the adult behavior collect all these data. And all these data has a tremendous role to formulate the ego state adult. Okay, the adult in us begins to form at around 10 months of old, and it the means by which we keep our parents and child under control. If we are to change our parent or adult, we must do so through adult. So we can say that parent is our thought concept. Sorry, parent is our thought concept, and adult is our thought concept, and child is our felt concept of life. And adult ego state is our thinking and feeling stage. Then adult ego state also two types, that is photographic adult and combining adult. Then this photographic adult is a part of personality which perceives which happening in here and there now, record, that is something recorded in our brain and we remember it and we report it later. It is more clear with an example. When somebody tells that you had worn the same dress in your party last week, that person is in his photographic adult stage. That is, he recorded the events in his brain and he reproduced it later. But in the case of combining adult, the combining adult is a part of personality which makes calculation using data. And actually, this combining adult receives data from the photographic adult and stored in its memory. But the thing is that a photographic adult calculates the probabilities and make prediction and does most of the reasoning. That is, give importance to reasoning and give importance to possibilities and try to make prediction. This is the difference between combining adult and photographic adult. The next one is child. Child is a state in which people behave, feel, and think similarly to how they did in the childhood. More clear with the help of an example. Suppose when a person who receives a poor evaluation at work, sometimes he may respond by looking at the floor, or sometimes he's crying. as they used to when scolding as a child. He imitating the same thing after when he entered into the adulthood. Okay, and suppose that person who receives good evaluation may respond with a broad smile and joyful gestures of thanks. A child is a source of emotions, creations, recreations, and intimacy. The child is the emotional ego state. All the primary emotions and their combinations, such as emotions such as anger, sadness, fear, shame, and on the other hand, love, joy, and all these are their origin in the child ego state. And the child is also two types, that is adopted child and free child. And adapted child developed when we learn to change our feelings and behavior in response to the world around us. Okay. And world around us, and that is some kind of anxiety and depression we learn from our surroundings, and we copying it to our life. And in some situation, an adapted child, then he's adapted to any situation, but in some situation he cannot cope up with those situations, but he's adapted to all those situations. Okay, through socialization we learn to take turn to share, to be friendly, to be concentrated about how something feels to others. We must learn the skill to get alone socially. This our adapted child to say please and thank you to others. However, this adapted child can become the most troublesome part of our personality. Okay, because an adapted child is always have the feelings that I'm not okay. But he's adapted to the situation. Okay. But in the free child have enough opportunity to express their feelings. They know how to love others and how to express their feelings. And they're very curious. We can trust the free child. They are loving and aggressive. Okay, the ability to manage our ego states is related to self-knowledge and healing of old emotional traumas, so that we are not subjected to fear and anger of the past and the resulting automatic reaction. These are about our ego state. Next is transactions. Transaction is the transactional stimulus plus transactional response. In the analysis of transaction, we use ego state model to help explain what goes on during the process of communication. Okay, there are mainly three types of transaction. They are basically three kinds of transaction. First one is reciprocal or complementary, and second one is crossed transaction, and third one is duplex or covert transaction. And the first one, that is a complementary or reciprocal transaction, as simple, that is the reciprocal transaction occurs when both partners addressing the same ego state. Okay, suppose if a person asking question to other one, because one person is asking from his adult ego state, the other one replied in the same adult ego state, then there is no problem. And this type of transaction is known as complementary transaction. And communication like this can be continuous indefinitely. Suppose both of them are giving and taking strokes, then it's a healthy transaction between that two person. And suppose it is a formal transaction, it may end with some sort of exchange. Okay. Then in crossed transactions, communication failure are typically caused by this crossed transaction, because the person interact each other in different ego state. This is the problem, and this crossed transaction makes so many problems in the workplace. That is, sometimes the authority or the supervisor may ask questions in his adult ego states, and suppose the workers may reply in the child or another stages, then it will leads to many conflicts. Okay, and crossed transaction may create so many problems. Okay, however, this is a risky transaction. And the third one is duplex. Another type of transaction is duplex transaction or covert transaction. where the explicit social conversation occurs in parallel with the implicit psychological transaction. This is the beside actual transaction, hidden words can read in between lines, which will definitely create problem. In duplex transaction, the hidden words can read in between line. That is the problem of this type of transaction. And next one is, the next element is life position. That is, in transactional analysis theory, this life position refers to the general feeling about life that colors every transaction. And there are four life positions proposed by Eric Byrne. That is, first one is, I am okay, you are okay. The people who under this I am okay, you are okay life position, their positive attitude, understand others, they are always happy and optimistic. And the second one is, I am not okay, you are not okay. They are emotionally unbalanced, trying to escape from the world of reality and lack of hope. These are the characteristics of the person who under this I am not okay, you are not okay. And third one is, I am okay, you are not okay. That is a type of superiority feelings, and always show a tendency to blaming others, and always have a feeling of perfect. That is, I'm okay, you are not okay. And the last one is, I'm not okay, you are okay. And this is a type of inferiority feeling, always blaming self and pessimistic, not always in a positive mind. These are the characteristics of this life position. And these are the four life position in transactional analysis theory. And the next one is life script. Okay, a script is a life plan directed to a reward. Actually, our life script is an unconscious pathway created in childhood, reinforced by our parents and strengthened with evidence sought throughout life, ensuring our beliefs are justified. Psychologists believe that an individual's life script get created in his childhood when he learns things unconsciously from the transaction between father, mother, and the child. That is, the life script may be developed from the early stages of life. That is, he may unconsciously be part of the conversation of the family members, and through that conversation, the life script may be developed. And we can rewrite our life script at any ages. Do you think life script can be changed? Yes, it can. That is the reply. Then, even a single question can change the life script. This is from a famous movie, How Old Are You? And as we know, the motivational experience from the film, How Old Are You? Changes are unexpected. We can change and rewrite our life script. But the thing is that we should accept that this is the time for change. That is one of the important things. And there is no age bar and there is no time. The thing is that we should realize the thing that this is the time for change. Change means identifying the potentialities, opportunities, and passion, and deciding to alter our current action and the way we intended and understood, and the way we are intended, we should change our the way of interaction with others and try to understand others and try to be ready to accept the things that are happening around us. That is, we can change at any age, at any time. The thing is that we should admit the fact that this is a time for change. Okay, the life script may develop by molding. That is, the ways we perceive adult and peer behavior. Sometimes certain attributions that is being told you are just like, and sometimes from certain suggestions that hints and encouragement, such as always you do your best, and sometimes from injections and counter injections, the demand to know to do or do things. Okay, all these things are also helps to write our life script. Okay, the next one is stroke. Actually, stroke is a unit of recognition. Okay, a stroke is a unit of attention which provides stimulation to an individual. We all have the hunger for recognition. We need physical and mental stimulus to overcome this hunger. And we know various type of recognition like pat, hug, smile, compliment or insult. All shows that our experience has been recognized. Eric Byrne uses the term recognition hunger to describe our need for this kind of acknowledgement from others. And there are so many types of strokes. Here we are going to discuss about some different types of strokes. First one is positive and negative stroke. As we know the term itself, a positive stroke is one which is received experience as pleasant. Okay, a word or a look itself is a positive stroke. For example, well done. Okay, it's a positive stroke. And at the same time, a negative stroke is one experienced as painful. Any kind of stroke is better than no stroke at all. That is, either positive or negative, it's beneficial for us and it is much better than no strokes. So try to give strokes to others. Okay, try to appreciate others, try to recognize others. And we also need recognition from others. We can ask recognition, that is, we can ask for strokes. And the first classification is positive and negative. And the second one is internal and external. That is, internal strokes is related to fantasies, self-praises, and other forms of self-stimulations. And the external strokes from others are important for healthy living. Actually, for healthy living, these external strokes are very important. As we know, internal motivation is more powerful, but external stroke has a prominent role in our life. Okay, and another type of classification is conditional or unconditional. That is, a conditional stroke related to what you do and unconditional stroke related to what you are. And the next classification is verbal and nonverbal. We are all familiar with these type of strokes, that is verbal and nonverbal. Then any transaction is an exchange of strokes. Most transaction involves this verbal and nonverbal exchange, that is verbal, awesome, or another thing, all the awesome or wonderful, all these are positive verbal stroke. And nonverbal means a hug or pat. Sometimes we can use our eyes to give strokes. All these are come to this nonverbal strokes. And another thing is stroke profile. A stroke profile helps to measure how a person gives and receives strokes in four categories. This can be effective therapeutic tool as a person can then decide to change any part of their stroking profile. That is, for example, a person may decide to stop discounting positive strokes and to ask for more of them. And this giving stroke is okay, saying no is okay, taking stroke is okay, asking for strokes is okay. And this stroke for profile is very useful for us. By using this stroke for profile, rate ourselves in each of the category above as to how often you do these things. Do above for the positive strokes and negative strokes. Okay, and the next one is game. And this games are powerful play for strokes. Okay, in our day-to-day life, we experience so many games. And the people play game by taking on the role in game. Usually, there are three roles. Sometimes, the rescuer and the victims appear in all games. Anyone who plays one of these roles will eventually play the other two. And if we can spot our game and nip them into the bud, we can move towards intimacy with the people around us and be more content as a result. Okay. And a series of duplex transactions which leads to switch and well-defined predictable playoff which justify I'm not okay or discount the position. And this games are actually a sort of tricks we are playing for the word of recognition, playing to get strokes. Okay. And then how can transactional analysis help us? Transactional analysis offers people a way to understand what is happening on a social level and within ourselves. It provides a map framework to start hanging experience on. This ego state helps us to identify where we are, once understood, we can figure out what is going on with their thinking, feeling, and behavior in a social group and choose to respond rather than react. So we have to be more knowledge which this ego state helps to be in a part of social groups and also identify the feelings of others. Okay, then the strokes, as we know, it's a unit of recognition. The unit of the stroke economy makes the poor behavior of some person more comprehensible and encouraged to be positive in their situation as a method of behavioral management. Okay, and games, there are so many games played in our day-to-day life. If we have an idea about the game people play, we can avoid them or at least be aware when they entered into them and avoid the negative payoff for themselves. Then live script, understanding that our own script which enable us to be in the right position both in personal and professional life. And through transaction analysis, we can gain more insight to human relationship. We can enter into a thick human relationship. And this transaction analysis provides us a language to explain why certain types of interaction are going to be more effective than others. And here, transaction analysis has so many implications, and transaction analysis is considered as a conflict resolution and also using transaction analysis for effective communication. That is, for effective communication, you need to keep the transactions complementary. That is, focus on sender to receiver and receiver to sender, where the message is sent to ego state and which you expected to replay. That while we are engaged in an interaction, we should aware about the ego state and we should consider the person who is sitting opposite to us. Then our communication will become more effective, then our communication will become more deeper, and transactional analysis helps you to interact with other people more effectively, more properly. And we can listen to people's communication, and a good communicator should be a good listener. And while we are learning about this transaction and analysis, which help us to be a patient listener, to be a patient listener. Okay, and this transaction analysis can be used to elicit the reaction we want from other people. Then transaction analysis that we can have considerable impact of modifying unsatisfactory behavior by the way we communicate with others. You use your adult ego state to think about what behavior is appropriate. The adult ego state has the capacity to control the other two ego states. Okay. And here, the three rules for communication in TA. First rule for communication: so long as transactions remain complementary, communication can continue indefinitely. This is the first rule of communication. And the second one is, when a transaction is closed, a break in communication results, and one or both individual will need to shift ego state in order for the communication to be re-established. This is the second rule. And the third rule is that the behavioral outcome of an ulterior transaction is determined at the psychological level and not at the social level. Actually, this transaction analysis is the study of social transaction between people. Okay, then this transaction analysis is frequently applied in the areas of medicine, communication, education, and business management, as well as therapy. The mainstream appeal to the techniques has attached parents, professionals, social workers, and others who strive to achieve maximum personal development. The transaction analysis is considered to be an effective method of enhancing relationship with oneself and with others. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Shalini ma'am, for that brilliant talk. And you have outlined all the important aspects of transactional analysis. Now, dear friends, now we are open to questions. If you have got any questions or queries, or if you need any clarification on some of the concepts shared by Dr. Shalini, you are free to ask and you are free to share your ideas as well. Welcome. It's an open forum now.
Dear participants, if you have any query, you can raise. Thank you, ma'am, for the wonderful session. We know the significance of communication in one's life, and you have shared Eric Berne's perspective about how transactional analysis plays a pivotal role in developing effective communication. I believe this session will be benefiting many of us. Being part of teaching fraternity, we can practically implement this theory into real classroom situation and encourage our students to develop communication. Thank you, ma'am.
Congrats, Dr. Shalini, for that brilliant presentation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
You have elaborated the ideas perfectly. Shall I ask one doubt? How can we reduce cross responses, Shalini? If somebody is talking in adult mode, are we supposed to talk in adult mode? Will it help us to avoid cross transactions?
Okay, sir. Actually, the thing is that when we are learning about this transaction analysis, while in a serious interaction, we can identify in which ego state we are interact with others. Suppose suppose two persons interact with each other, and one is in an adult stage, and another one is and suppose I am asking questions in my adult ego state, and Joju sir is replied in your child ego state. Okay, then surely there will be a conflict. So it is better to avoid such type of situation. If we can ask the person to try to be more serious while I am asking such type of questions, and be patient. The thing is that we should consider the circumstances in which the other person is replay, the other person environment, his attitude, and then we can reply properly.
Consider, let me share you a situation when we are talking seriously to a person, but the other person is in a joking childish mood. So we are supposed to help them to come back to adult mode. Am I correct, ma'am?
Yes. Then we can give proper direction to come that person to the adult mode, because we can convey the message that this is a serious problem, and we give much importance to this problem, and we can give suggestions to be serious in that particular issue. That is the way we can correct the other person.
Thank you, teacher. Thanks a lot, teacher. That's what I was thinking.
Thank you, sir.
Any queries in the chat box? Check the chat box, please.
No, sir.
Okay. Benedict sir, shall we move on to the concluding part then? Hello, friends. Kindly move on to the concluding part,
Hello.
Please.
Benedict sir. Congratulations, Dr. Shalini, for your nice presentation, excellent presentation. Unfortunately,
thank you, sir.
Couldn't join in between. There was a few interruptions here at the office. So I couldn't completely hear, but I know that you have presented very, very elaborately. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Dear friends, one second. Dear friends, next Monday, we have got Dr. Vidya from Chennai for an outstanding talk on mind power development and self-help talk. Now, we would like all of you to join next Monday also. Share the story of insight in depth with your friends, and the video will be uploaded in YouTube as well if you want to go through the video once again. Thank you for joining. Now, research scholars, move on to the concluding part, please. Thank you.
Sure, sir. With that, we are moving to the last segment of the program to express our sincere gratitude to each one present here and making this a wonderful program. I invite Swamiji to deliver a vote of thanks. Swamiji?
Hello, am I audible now?
Yes, Swamiji.
Okay. before moving on to the delivering vote of thanks, let me tell one word or one sentence, please. whatever information we are getting, if we are able to practice that in our life, it will become our knowledge. And if we are able to practice that knowledge without much effort and for the benefit of others, it becomes wisdom. So we are getting immense information from these talks, through the insight in-depth talks. Fully, we are able to imbibe the wisdom of that person, we will be able to develop our knowledge and move on to our wisdom. So let's let this insight in the talk series be a path for that, a platform for that. Actually, it is a great pleasure and privilege to offer a vote of thanks in this program, because today's resource person is my beloved teacher, Shalini. Ma'am, really it was an excellent talk from your side. What I felt is that you discussed much about the different styles, different transaction methods, and how to overcome all these things. We have to be very cautious in our transactions. First of all, we must avoid from playing games. And the second one, we must not fall into the games played by others. So we have to keep these two things in our mind, that so that we could be always reflective in our life. So it was a great pleasure to offer a word of thanks to you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you very much, ma'am. Really, we are highly indebted to our beloved principal, Dr. K.Y. Benedict, sir, for his immense leadership qualities, and our Dr. Jyoti Jones, sir, our research coordinator, for giving us this much immense help in all the ways possible. There are much people working in behind this insight in the talks. Today, we have to thank Vinci Biju, who did the comparing, then Anuja V.S., who did the welcome speech, who and Mika Suresh Koshi, who introduced the guest, and all the faculty members of Marathi of Less Training College, and other faculty members who are assembled here. Also, all the research scholars, the students, and all the people who are assembled here, we from the side of Marathi of Less Training College, we offer a heartfelt thanks to all. We are extremely thankful to each and every person who are assembled here. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Swamiji. Now, dear Hello. Friends, Benedict sir has pointed out the importance of today, and C.P. Srikandan Nair sir, an esteemed educationist, has passed away from this world and he has moved on to eternal rest and eternal bliss. Let's all stand up and pay respect to C.P. Srikandan Nair sir for 1 minute before singing the national anthem, please. Thank you. Thank you, Benedict sir, for reminding that. All of you are requested to fill in the feedback form. National anthem, please.
Yes, sir. The participants, link for e-certificate is posted in the chat box. Kindly fill it. Now, we are moving to the last session. The program will get over after the national anthem being played. Kindly stay tuned with us for national anthem. Thanks again for joining us today. See you next Monday.
जनगणमन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा जनगणमन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
இனி எந்த எடுக்கணும்
டாய்லெட் கிளீனர்
ஏது
ஹார்பிக்